Tell her for love, everybody. I'm Poetic, and this is Did You Know?
Now, if you ain't from the ghetto, don't come to the ghetto unless you got a pass or fit.
I'm known for hip hop, that's how I get down. Some days you make $1 million, some days you make nothing. So in order to put bread and butter on the table, we venture out and do a couple of other things, and this is what it's about. So this right here, this is the Fela Cavalli, a.k.a. the G-Robs. This is where we get everything prepped for the outgoing. That's on the online store and also the market. So everything you see hanging up here is getting ready for the market run in Oakland on the weekends.
I made $100 off of clothing. Spent it on the music just to stay independent.
Yeah, so this is how we fund the music, by this business here. And it all goes full circle, comes back around with touring as well. This actually started with 30 t-shirts out the trunk of my car. Every weekend we're at the markets, Thursday to Sunday. And we got 5 different CDs here for sale. And we also got 113 different garments at the moment. All right, we're now over here at the Common Goods Live Print Warehouse. This is where all the magic happens, like this, you know what I'm saying? Come in, follow me in.
We started this from nothing, bro, from a dream. Dollar in a dream. We started in the chicken shack in Mokoto.
Started on Sabo first, and then we came to New Zealand. Like, hey, give it a go, and here we go. For the village. This is 685 music. So the order will come. I think that order is from Russia, I think. That's the one. So 2 t-shirts. So we get 2 of these. Boom. Straight to Russia.
The island way, the Samo that we were raised with, is to serve. You serve the village, you serve the people, you serve God and your family. So we incorporate that into our brand. Everything we do is for the village. How many rappers you know ride around the city selling
CDs out the trunk like it was the late 80s? Even when I smoke. We're going to Manhattan to drop off a special package. So when it's like that, sometimes we can do these little drops when I got time in between meetings and stuff.
For me, one of the hardest things to do when you're hustling at the markets is pulling up on a bad day. And a bad day can mean you might sell 1 t-shirt. That's not even enough to pay your rent for your table. Those days are the hardest to get through. But one thing that I learned from it is to always stay working, always stay moving forward. Hard work is how you come up.
That's how you build your name. It's always cool to wake up and not answer to nobody. You know what I mean? Like, I like the fact that we're our own business, our own boss. We're independent. We get to do things the way we want to do things. And you got more space to grow that way. This is still a young business for us, but we've left so much room to grow and get bigger, so we're just trusting the process and enjoying the journey, you know what I'm saying? She give me